Here's another 15 Excel 2016 tips and tricks. This is a compilation of 15 additional Excel 2016 tips and tricks that didn't make it in my previous top 25 Excel tips and tricks video. If you haven't seen it, you'll want to click the link listed at the end of this video in the description below, or the suggested video shown right here. Following the same format as my previous videos, I'm going to show you some powerful tips and tricks to help you become more proficient with Excel 2016. Let's get started. Number one, move columns and rows. Most people copy and paste data, but you've been doing it all wrong. All you have to do is click on a column, wait till the cursor changes, and then drag it and move it. You can do it on a row too. And you guessed it, you can even highlight a section of cells. That's the right way to do it. Number two, name a range. Naming a range is very helpful to refer to sets of data. Most people go to formulas, click on define name, they type in the name they want, and they click this button to select the data set and hit OK. Now you have a named North data range. But there's a better method. Let's say in this example, I want North, South, West, and East all to be named. The best thing to do is to highlight all of the data first, then go to Create from Selection, choose the top row for the name value, which is the North, South, West, East, hit OK, and it automatically creates all of the data sets with those names for you. Remember to select the data range first. It's a much better method. Number three, status bar totals. If you want quick access to some totaling, just click on a range of cells, and down in the bottom status bar area, you'll see the average, count, and sum. You can even select holding the control key and choose a variety of different things in different locations, and it will show you that average, count, and sum for those. If you right-click on the status bar, you can add minimum and maximum to that list as well. So now you can see those totals. This is a quick way to see some summary information without having to create formulas. Number four, insert multiple lines. If you want to insert rows, you usually will highlight a row, right-click, and choose Insert, and it inserts one line. Same thing's true on columns. Right-click, Insert, inserts one. What if you want to do more than one? All you have to do is highlight multiple lines, and then at the top, right-click, and choose Insert. That puts in the number of highlighted lines that you selected. Same thing works on columns. Save yourself some time and do multiple lines. Number five, F4 absolute reference. When you have a formula, you often use absolute references. So if you put a dollar sign in front of the column and in front of the row, that makes B3 an absolute cell reference. So when you move data around, it's always going to stay B3 in this formula, irregardless. A viewer mentioned a shortcut key, which is the F4 function key. If I hit F4 on this C5, it makes it an absolute reference C5. You can hit it again, and it cycles through the various choices for no absolute reference to column and row both, just row, just column, and back to none. That's a quick method to enter those absolute references. Thanks for the tip. Number six, difference between lists. You often need to find the differences between two lists. It may be that you copy this information over each month or each week and you want to compare one to the next. I'm putting them together on the same sheet just for the example, but all you do is you highlight the first one, hold the control key down, and then highlight the second one. That's fine if it's on a different sheet, different tab. You can select it with the control key held down. Now that you've selected both lists, go to Conditional Formatting on the Home tab. Choose Highlight Cell Rules, and select Duplicate Values. Now you can change this to unique, hit OK, and now it highlights the cells that are different between those two lists. That's the quick method to find differences. Number 7, data entry limits. You can restrict data that's entered into a specific cell. So take this A2 cell as an example. I'm going to go to Data, Data Validation, and I'm going to select from the list whole numbers because I want the value in here to only be whole numbers between 60 and 250. For an input message, I can say what is valid is only 60 to 250. And if there's an error and they select something outside of that, I'm going to tell them not a valid entry and hit OK. Now you'll notice that it highlights this cell and it gives me this information, only 60 to 250. If I try to type something outside of that range, it gives me an error message and says this is not a valid entry. Retry lets you re-enter. It's a great way to limit the data that can be entered into your spreadsheets. Number 8, trend line in charts. If you ever wanted to add a trend line to a graph, Excel has an option to do this. Let's say I want to take this data right here and create a graph. And on this graph, I want to add a trend line that shows the flow of the data. You can go over here to this Add Chart element, come down to Trend Line, and I prefer to choose More Trend Line Options. That brings up the menu over here. And you can choose from a variety of trend line types, exponential, linear, logarithmic. I prefer this polynomial one. That gives you a nice smooth line that represents the data. And that's how you do trend lines. Number 9, Ctrl-Tab. Here's a shortcut if you have multiple spreadsheets open. You're used to doing Alt-Tab to switch between different applications, but if you hit Ctrl-Tab, it switches you between your Excel files. Number 10, split or combine names. It's pretty common to have a spreadsheet with first, middle, and last names in separate columns, and you want to create a full name. The easiest way to do that is to put this formula in to add the names together. This adds a space in between each one, and you end up with the full name combined. Then you can take it and drag it down for the full list. Now, one step you also want to take is to highlight that column, do a copy, and paste special as values. This takes the formulas out and leaves the data the way you want it. Now the second common thing you run into is where the full names combine and you want to break it out into first, middle, and last name. To do that, you want to use this formula for the first name. And what we're doing is we're taking the left of D2 for how many characters? Well, wherever we find the space in D2 minus one character. So that leaves us with John. And for the middle, you want to use this formula. And essentially, this formula looks for the mid string of data starting with where the first space is plus one character and then going to where the second space is, that number of characters, and that ends up pulling out the name Lee. Big, long, confusing formula, but if you copy that text, you should be able to use it in your own formulas. For the last name, use this formula. We're taking the right number of characters from where the second space is forward. And that leaves you this long formula here, which you can copy. You can double click to copy those down and it gets all the first, middle, and last names. And do the same thing and copy and paste special as values. That gets rid of the formulas and you're set. Number 11, proper function. Let's say those names are not properly formatted. Well, there is a function called proper that allows you to do the correct upper and lower case. All you have to do is type in proper, parentheses, select the cell, and there you have the right formatting. Copy that down, and you've fixed all of the formatting for those names. Number 12, mean, median, and mode. The mean, median, and mode are common statistical calculations, and you can create those in Excel. For the mean, it is essentially the average formula. So I'm going to take the average of all of these numbers, and it comes up with 141. The median is the middle number, and there is a function called median. So if we take the median of the same set of numbers, that is the number. It is in the exact middle position of all of those numbers. And mode is the most frequently used number, and there is a mode function available as well. It shows 228 because 228 is in the list twice. If you didn't have a repeat of the same number, then there would be no mode. And that's how you use mean, median, and mode in Excel. Number 13, payment function. Another common and helpful function in Excel is the PMT function. It allows you to calculate loan payments. And in this example, I'm entering in a percentage as 0.05, but formatting this as 5%, that represents the annual rate. And I'm choosing 60 months as the number of payments and an original loan amount of $20,000. To create the payment function, just type equals PMT, left parenthesis, and it's first going to ask for the rate, which is this one. Now, a key you got to remember here is that's an annual rate, and since you're doing a monthly payment, you need to make sure to divide this by 12 so that you have 12 months out of the year. Then you enter the number of periods, which in this case is 60, and the present value of the loan amount. Now, there's parameters here for future value and type. We're not going to use those, but those are available if you want more complex loan calculations. I'm going to do the in parentheses and hit enter. And there is my monthly payment amount. Now it defaults to a negative number, and a quick way to change that is to put a minus in front of the formula there, and it reverses it to a positive number. That tells you that you have $377.42 per month for 60 months on a $20,000 loan at 5% interest rate. You can use this kind of formula to calculate car loan payments or a variety of other calculations. Number 14. COUNTBLANK function. Another helpful function in Excel is COUNTBLANK. Just type in COUNTBLANK in parentheses and highlight whatever range you want to find all the blanks. It tells you there are 7, and it does it across rows and columns. It's whatever area that you select. Simple little tool, but helpful. Number 15, date time shortcut. Did you know you can insert the date and time on your spreadsheet with a simple shortcut? For the date, press Control semicolon, and for the time, Control Shift semicolon. It's as simple as that. Stay tuned for more Excel training tips and tricks, and feel free to make suggestions in the comments below for any topics you'd like me to cover in future videos. Thanks for watching. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.